that we've known for a long time. I haven't seen him now in maybe 15 years. Phil Clark was his name. He was the bartender. When we were hanging out in Key West, we first got there. Here was a real pirate. We'd heard
he was
about him.
The real pirate.
There's yeah, I mean, you just it. Knew it. He had that kind of that kind of breath in those eyes. So.
Phil Clark was the bartender, and what we, he basically, his system was that anybody he liked who were the locals, he would always get the tourists that checked in the hotel pretty gassed up, and then he would charge all of our drinks to them.
Definitely a pirate.
I love America, you know. he was really that, and there was always something going on, and he was either heading to Providenciales. I mean, you know, he put words in my vocabulary that later became songs and stories about it. And so he was. I remember seeing him sail away with his girlfriend one day off to some exotic island, and I was like, God, I wish I could grow up to be a pirate like him. And I didn't get to do that, but it inspired all of that old Treasure Island kind of stuff. You know, I was always a young Jim Hawkins fan from way back. And Phil Clark died about 10 years ago.
Oh, that's why I didn't see.
And yeah, he hadn't been around. Well, but there's a happy ending to this story.
Well, I mean, if you hadn't told me that, I'd think he's still around. I mean, I was waiting for every time I go to Key West, I look around.
Well, I tell you what, if you'd like to see Phil, I mean, in a way, it's true, because his ashes are in an urn atop the Full Moon Saloon cash register.
All right.
Yeah. And they brought him back there, and they put half of
him. Then I have seen him.
You have seen him. He would laugh at this, believe me. This song was, it's become, I guess, it's truly one of my favorites, and most people that have been with this music for all these years, it seems to be their favorite, too. I guess we all wanted to grow up and be pirates at some point, and when we get to that part about what to, it's not the best economic strategy at all, but everybody seems to like to sort of snarl that line out, so you're welcome. You know what I'm talking about, don't you?
Yeah, okay.
See? Arrgh. Mother, mother ocean, I have heard you call, wanted to sail upon your waters since I was 3 feet tall. You've seen it all. You've seen it all. Watch the man who rode you switch from sail to steam. In your belly you can hold the treasures you have ever seen, most of them dream, most of them dream. Yes, I am a pirate, 200 years too late. Cannons don't thunder, there's nothing to plunder. I'm an over 40 victim of fate. Arriving too late, arriving too late. I've done a bit of smuggling, I've run my share of grass, made enough money to buy Miami, but I pissed it away so fast. Never meant to last. Never meant to last. Now I have been drunk now for over 2 weeks, passed out and I rallied and I sprung a few leaks. But I got to stop wishing, got to go fishing. I'm down to rock bottom again, just a few friends. just a few friends. Play it, Mr. Taylor. Yeah. Fingers' his favorite verse. Now I go for younger women, live with several a while. Though I ran them away, hey, they'd come back one day, and they still could manage a smile. Just takes a while. Just takes a while. Mother, Mother Ocean, after all my years I found occupational hazard being my occupation's just not around. Feel like I've drowned, but I won't wear frowns. Feel like I've drowned. Get drunk uptown.